time for us to go for a short break. Stay with us. We will introduce you to a lady coach in our sports section coming up next.
If man is born free, why do some have to hide in the jungles and live in fear? Violence, extortions, bomb blasts bring nothing but unhappiness, destruction and ruin. Militants who have returned to the mainstream and have chosen to be rehabilitated have chosen happiness. What is a life which cannot bring happiness to oneself and others? Live happily, live in peace. First Word, a complete monthly magazine of the Northeast, packaging news and current affairs, sports, culture, festivals, achievers, life in metro and lots more. Buy the magazine today from stalls across the Northeast and New Delhi, or subscribe for 12 issues by paying Rs. 320 online. For details, contact 98101-29327.
Welcome back, friends. Though cycles are a humble mode of transport, the world of cycling competition and tournaments is very professional and competitive, with cyclists using very high-tech cycles. Let's meet a lady coach to know more.
As a sport, cycling is increasingly becoming popular in the Northeast, even though cyclists want the Government and Sports Authority of India to make available modern high-tech lightweight cycles. Gautamani Devi of Manipur, who started as a state-level champion from Manipur and went on to represent the nation internationally in Korea, Kazakhstan and many other countries before becoming a coach of the national team, said so to Youthfolio.
हम लोग को उधर स्टेट लेवल किया था, then उसके बाद फिर नेशनल करके फिर then साग गेम में ऐसे मेडल लिया था हम लोग करके, फिर उसके बाद फिर कोस में मतलब प्लेयर खत्म होके फिर कोस में आ गया, फिर उसके बाद इंटरनेशनल लेवल में हम लोग इसमें किया 11-11-2 कोरिया में किया, फिर ऐसे करके फिर एशियन चैम्पियनशिप में भी मैं इंडिया टीम का कोच बनी और कॉमनवेल्थ गेम देन उसके बाद उसमें साग गेम में भी ऐसे इंडिया टीम का कोच बनी।
इन गौतामणि स्टेट मणिपुर वन कैन सी मेनी साइक्लिस्ट्स प्रैक्टिसिंग इन खुमान लामपाक स्टेडियम फ्रॉम द मॉर्निंग मेनी साइक्लिस्ट्स इवन गो ऑन रैली taking up causes like violence against women, and yet they are besieged with problems like other sports people, from law and order disturbances to bandh and blockade, which affects them adversely.
वो दिक्कत पड़ता है हमारा जो भी है मणिपुर का राइडर यहाँ तक मतलब केम तक आ नहीं सकती क्योंकि उन लोगों का परफॉर्मेंस डाउन होता है ट्रेनिंग जाने के लिए मतलब अंदर खुमला पार्क पे जाने के लिए मतलब बन ब्लॉकेट हो जाती है तो अंदर पे बेलोड्रोम नहीं था तो जाना पड़ता है साई ताल से तो उन लोग को बहुत दिक्कत पड़ता है फिर बारिश हो जाता है ट्रेनिंग करने के लिए दिक्कत पड़ती है रास्ते के लिए तो फिर मतलब फ्री से कर नहीं सकती
बिफोर लीविंग अस दस गौतमनी गिव्स अ मैसेज फॉर पीस
आपस में लड़ाई न करें और शांति मिलकर मतलब अच्छा से प्यार से रहे और मतलब एक यूनिटी बनाकर रहे
Well, friends, we are nearing the end of our episode time. But before we bid adieu, check out a few current job vacancies in the Northeast. Who knows, one of them could be a dream job for you or your friends who are hunting.
Super 6 Products Private Limited requires regional sales managers for the Northeast at Agartala, Guwahati and Imphal. The company is looking for graduate candidates. Tezpur University has vacancies for junior research fellows. The required qualification is post-graduation in physics with NET. ASG Eye Hospital Private Limited is hunting for retina surgeons at Guwahati. MBBS degree holders can apply here. Hills Cement Company Limited requires sales executives at Dibrugarh, Sibsagar, Jorhat and Golaghat. The company wants graduate candidates. VLCC Healthcare has openings for dietitians and slimming heads at Silchar. Candidates who apply should have BSc in food technology.
The devotional atmosphere of the Buddhist monasteries of Arunachal Pradesh came alive in New Delhi with a performance of Buddhist chanting organized by the Sangeet Natak Academy. Watch on.
The picturesque state of Arunachal Pradesh is one of the most peaceful states of the country. With gompas and monasteries scattered all over the state and having a very positive influence on the people, irrespective of communities they come from, it is understandable that people are God-fearing and peaceful in nature who abide by ways shown by their monks. It is common to see people, young and old, lighting butter lamps and praying at gompas morning and evening. This atmosphere of ethereal godliness was brought alive by 10 monks of Arunachal Pradesh's Buddhist monasteries in Delhi during the Festival of Intangible Cultural Heritage of India, held between the 25th to the 27th of March. The monks chanted for world peace.
Arunachal is a very peaceful area, and the place also very peaceful, and the people are very innocent, and always that the Buddhist monk are there and they go for prayers and everything. So people believe in prayers and that Buddhist monk, and they listen to them. That's why still now there is a peaceful.
Arunachal se aaye hue aur hum log dost log hai to हम आज से दिल्ली में आया है तो बहुत खुशी लगा और हम यहाँ में चैंटिंग यानी पीसफुल के लिए वर्ल्ड पीसफुल के लिए चैंटिंग करना चाह रहा है.
The monk started the function with a bathing ceremony of God, which was accompanied by beating of drums and playing of instruments. Acharya, secretary of the Sangeet Natak Academy, told Youthfolio that the academy was in the process of majorly highlighting traditions of the Northeast and how musicians from all over the country bond with each other during the functions, thus promoting unity through culture.
I feel that the culture, the practice of our culture, is the most strong binding factor for our whole nation. And you know, the beauty is that when we bring the artists from the Northeast and they are presented with the artists of the Southern region and Western region and Eastern region, you know, there is such a beautiful interaction among them, and ultimately by the end of the festival each one is exchanging their instruments, they're exchanging their songs, and somewhere they feel that these boundaries are just man-made. And we are all one as humans, and we all have our beautiful artistic expression.
Well, viewers, I hope you enjoyed watching the show as much as we enjoyed compiling it for you. The lucky winners of this week are...
For our contest section, we had asked, which sport did we show? The answer is... rock climbing. And the winners are... Long Kim from Kolasib, Mizoram, GM Tara from Itanagar, Arunachal Pradesh, and Momin Khanduk from Silchar, Assam.
Congratulations, winners! We will recharge your mobiles with rupees 1000 each. Others who want similar recharges can answer a simple question. Name the cycling coach interviewed for this episode. Send in your answers to youth_folio@yahoo.com or SMS to 9954024434. Don't forget to tune into Youthfolio next Thursday at 7:30 p.m. Until then, goodbye and take care of yourself.